Yo, yo, YouTube, what's crack-a-lack-a-jack-a-smackin', it's Wolfman for video. I was supposed to have a My Team video out today, but of course PlayStation Network is down. But anyways, we got some more NBA free agency talk, more NBA free agency news for the Knicks. Knicks are gonna sign Robin Lopez, the center from the Portland Trail Blazers, to a 4-year, $54 million deal. He's gonna be making about 12 to 13 million a year. And you know, for a big man of that size that plays defense, he's a 7-footer. He doesn't average a double-double in points or rebounds. So, I mean, I was kind of surprised at the deal. You know, we weren't able to get LaMarcus Aldridge or DeAndre Jordan, who was signing with the Mavs. We'll talk about that very quickly soon. But Robin Lopez is a 7-footer. He's still 27 years old. You know, he has a lot of good things to improve upon. And, you know, honestly, this was a decent to good signing. We have Aaron Aflalo, you know, that plays defense. Phil Jackson is trying to build a defensive-oriented team because you need defense to win championships. And, you know, we didn't make any splashes in this free agency yet. We're trying to sign Corey Brewer now. Might fit the triangle system. But this is a 2-year process, man. So, honestly, us Knicks fans, we just have to be patient now because it's going to be until next free agency. And think about it. For next free agency, we're going to have $30 million in cap space, man. So, Knicks fans, don't worry. Robin Lopez is on the team for next season. Aaron Aflalo has a player option. If he decides to decline that player option, we'll have even $38 million in cap space next season. So just wait, man. We still have Carmelo on contract. If anything, we can still trade Carmelo for any pieces, you know, get a draft pick and stuff like that. So we're in a pretty decent position right now. We have Kristaps Porzingis. We have Jerian Grant. We still have Langston Galloway. And, you know, we have a solid future, man. We just be patient with the building process, actually. But as far as DeAndre Jordan goes, wow. 4 years, $80 million to the Dallas Mavericks. He's going to be making $20 million a year. $2 million less than Carmelo Anthony every year. I mean, that's crazy, man. That is ridiculous. I mean, yo, I'm surprised he left Clippers and Chris Paul and Blake Griffin. I mean, I guess he wanted to be a second option on the team or the man on the team that badly, but I'm surprised he didn't come to New York. I guess we weren't offering him $20 million, because that is a lot, man. I mean, he plays great defense, definitely one of the best defensive centers in the league. But man, I mean, it's just so weird. To the Mavericks, though, like, first of all, the Mavericks are not really in a position to be title contenders for a while. I mean, they still got Dirk Nowitzki, but they lost Monte Ellis, they lost Rajon Rondo, they lost Tyson Chandler. They just lost a lot of pieces. They're probably going to lose Amari Stoudemire. They still got Chandler Parsons, but, you know, the Mavericks are not a team who I see them getting out of the second round. The freaking, not even the first round. Not let alone, who knows if they'll even make the playoffs. I mean, we don't even know yet. And, I mean, I don't think they're going to sign anybody else. And I'm still surprised. I mean, I guess DeAndre Jordan does live in Texas. Someone told me that. But still, to pick, I mean, the Clippers are just completely, I don't even see them making it to the NBA Finals anymore, man. I'm sorry, I don't see them making the Western Conference Finals. Not in the West, man. Not losing DeAndre Jordan makes such a huge impact on that team. You don't understand. The team is going to be so different. But anyways, YouTube, give me your thoughts on these two moves, and I'm out. Peace.